Well, good evening. Well, don't be shy. Just let your feelings roll on by. And don't wear fear. Oh, nobody will know you're there. Just lift your head and let your feelings out instead. And don't be shy. Just let your feelings roll on by. On by, on by. On by, on by, on by. On by, on by. On by, on by. You know, love is better than a song. Yeah, love is where all of us belong. Just let your feelings roll on by. And don't wear fear, or nobody will know you're there. You're there, you're there. You're there, you're there, you're there. You're there, you're there, you're there. You're there, you're there. So don't be shy, just let your feelings roll on by. And don't wear fear, how nobody will know you're there. Just lift your head and let your feelings out instead. And don't be shy, just let your feelings roll on by. On by, 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 on by. The conscious mind, find myself to be so inclined. Why sleep and discontent? All the price of companionship. My shadow runs with me as we reach the big white zone. My shadow runs with me as we leave it all. We leave it all. As well, allow a creator sense of will. Why contain oneself like any other book on the shelf? My shadow runs with me underneath the big white zone. My shadow comes with me. We'll be right back. Hear the subtle voices in the wind. Hear the truth they're telling. My world begins with the running on me. Leave me all behind. Fall behind. Fall behind. Hey, 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 hey. All right, thank you. This is my friend Chris Chelios. Chris, it's just a little bit early for tequila. I will join you late. But thanks for the offer. Thank you, Chris. Everybody say thanks to Chris. Well, it is so good to just hang out with you. Play some music and talk some story. It feels like a beautiful backyard with more friends than I could have ever imagined having. And last year we put some clips of past Ohanas together. We called it like a virtual Ohana because everything was fucking virtual last year. And I don't know if you saw it, but I made some pickled margaritas and all this shit. But I realized when I was watching it back that we were up here playing Hard Sun, and it was me and Glenn Hansard and Kelly Slater, and even me mom was up here. But I realized that had been the last time that we had played or been in front of people. And I started to get misty and upset, and it wasn't because I missed it, but it was just seeing all the people together and a joyous occasion. It just seemed, a year ago, it seemed like you couldn't even imagine it ever happening again. So being here tonight, it's... And we're not all the way through it, but having witnessed this weekend and the bands and the crowds and the type of people that have been here and the way they've treated each other treated us, we're not through it yet, but man, this really gives me faith, and I thank you. Such is the way of the world, you can never know just where to put all your faith and how will it grow. Gonna rise up, burning black holes and dark memories. Gonna rise up, turning mistakes into gold. Oh, such is the passage of time, too fast to fold. Yeah, suddenly swallowed by signs, lo and behold. Gonna rise up, find my direction magnetically. Gonna rise up, throw down in the hole.
My middle name's Jerome, actually.
Close.
I had a beautiful communication today with the three brothers from Kings of Leon, and they're just going through, they're going through it, because they really lost a, you know, they lost their mom yesterday, and I'm lucky enough to have gotten to know her over the years, and she was truly a magnificent lady, and I'm thinking about them, and I'm also thinking about another friend that I lost. I consider him a friend. I think he did too. But it was just a week ago, and I saw some clips. You would know who he was, but I looked back and I was watching him, and the thing about dying and funerals came up, and it was, he was on film saying, you know, all those things about people saying when they die that they don't want a funeral, they want a big party, and they want everyone to just be happy and don't be, you know, just enjoy, just celebrate, whatever. And he said, you know, fuck that shit. I want them to be upset and crying and just not being able to wake up in the morning and staying in bed all day for a week. He said, you know, you got your whole fucking life to be happy and have a fucking party. When I die, I want you to fucking be depressed. So this is from my friend Norm MacDonald. I was a neutron bomb and I would never go on. I wish I were a sacrifice, but somehow still lived on. I wish I were a sentimental ornament that you hung on. In a Christmas tree, I wish I were the star that went on top. Oh, I wish I was the evidence. I wish I were the sound of all Doheny's hands up and raised and open towards the sky. That's it, you got it. Come on. Yeah. I wish I was a sailor with someone who waited for me. I wish I was as fortunate as fortunate as Doheny. I wish I was the messenger and all the news was good. Oh, I wish I was the full moon shining off Bruce Springsteen's hood. I wish I was a living being at home behind the sun. I wish I were the souvenir you kept your house key on. I wish I was the pedal brake that you depended on. I wish I were the verb to trust and I'll never I let you down. And I never let you down. All right. Thanks for coming. we have, this is the first Ohana that I get to have more than one special guest. It's a thrill to be able to be playing with these guys, and especially be playing the music that we've been working on and that we've been putting out recently that without them we couldn't play. And the first one, I'm gonna welcome him back to the stage, all the way from Ireland. My greatest friend, Mr. Glenn Hanser. I was gonna tell him about this time a few years ago. We were playing in Europe, touring, and we got invited by the wonderful Danny Harrison and Olivia Harrison, George's wife. Olivia, wonderful person. But we got invited to visit Friar Park, which was George's and Olivia's castle. And it is a castle. And I think we even spent the night, yeah? And, you know, it was such an incredibly intense experience. We were grateful that we had a day off the next day as well, because we were vibrating so intensely from where George lived, what he had done with the place. And also there was a room with all the guitars. The Let It Be Telecaster from the roof. The Fender Strat, the Rickenbacker Hard Day's Night, first chord, you know. And Danny's saying, here, just play it, and then I'm not worthy and all that. But there's this one acoustic called the J160E. Glenn fell in love with it, and it took me a few years, but I found him one and gave it to him today. He was talking about it. And the only reason I'm bringing it up is because I know you love it. And I know you were getting teary and I was getting teary. But this next song that we're gonna play is all about not becoming attached to material possessions. So I think this is an example where maybe an exception can be made. Maybe you need your new one. See, that one's jealous. That's what they do. They have, you know. I'm gonna start it, and then yeah. Which we have agreed. And you think you have to want more than you need. Until you have it all, you won't be free. Society, you're a crazy breed. Hope you're not lonely without. I need to find a bigger place. 'Cause when
want more than you think, you need more space. Society, you're a crazy breed. Hope you're not lonely without me. Society, crazy indeed. Hope you're not lonely without me. Butterflies is more, and we keep in score. Means for every point you make, your level drops. Kinda like starting from the top. And you can't do that, society. You're crazy, breed. Hope you're not lonely without. Society, crazy indeed. Hope you're not lonely without me. Society, have mercy on me. Hope you're not angry if I disagree. Oh, society, crazy indeed. Hope you're not lonely. Some songs. It's so good to hear people singing them. Those were from Into the Wild, and that was such an important. Since day one, and Sean invited me to be part of it. It's been a huge part of my life, and it's connected with so many people. The story of Chris McCandless, because of Sean and what he was able to do with it. I never thought I'd get to experience that kind of magic again, but just this last year or two, we started working on something, it's a beautifully intense and intensely beautiful film that Sean made this year called Flag Day, and he's here tonight, so I don't want to embarrass him too much, you see, but I think it'll be okay. He's incredible in it, and his daughter, Dylan, is just fucking incredible in it. And then we were fortunate to get asked to do some of the music, all of the music, between myself, Glenn, Sean Marshall, and another lovely lady. We got to do
the film soundtrack, and because we're all gathered here, we get to play it tonight. Can we introduce the band? Yeah. Mr. Andrew Watt on the guitar. Mr. Pino Palladino on the bass. Josh Klinghoffer on guitar and keyboards. Glenn's playing harmonium. And we have a big engine here, Mr. Chad Smith under the hood. And we're just a bit nervous because some of the men and fellas in Pearl Jam are here as well tonight. A little nervous. Yeah, it's more music, right? They're good with it. Baby, This is another flag. Next song's called Be Waiting. Let's make sure you can hear your piano. That's good. Okay. Oh, here's Glenn. This is a song called Tender Mercies.
It came to nothing. This longing. This love. You tender mercies. Thank you. verses weren't enough.
Since it feels like the perfect wave, we're gonna try a board we've never surfed before. We're gonna play this one even though you've never heard it. I'm committing ourselves as a group that this is gonna be a great version of the song. It's gonna be the first version of the song. I hope it's. We could wait until we put it out, but I thought, you know. So I would hope you'd be like, oh, I remember when they played that the first time. Now that's if we don't fuck it up. So we're not. It's called The Haves, and it's about the haves and the have-nots. When you wake up, it just might be the first of many blows that you receive. What we need, we want what we need. We need what's above. We find ourselves reaching for something above. But we've got enough. All of the hells they have.
Live to live, yeah. We want what we need. We We're putting the whole family to work tonight. This little ukulele, I've played it here before. It's built in 1950, right about the same time they invented the electric guitar pickup. Somebody very inventive, or maybe got some marijuana from some of the jazz musicians that were passing through town in the 1950s, decided to put this pickup on a fucking ukulele. It's a real life Gibson ukulele. Now, I've played it before, but you know, you have these conversations with these little instruments. This one always wanted to play with the big boys. It always wanted to play with like a Matt Cameron, or a Chad Smith, or a Stuart Copeland, you know, one of the greats. Because it gets loud. This little guy's gonna start it out. Mick Jones, thank you, Joe Strummer. Endless Strummer. That was Mr. Josh Klinghoffer right there. You'll see Josh tomorrow night too, which is good. So, what's up, how much time? Plenty of time. How's everybody out there? Okay. I know I usually don't drink during a solo show, but is there a bottle of red wine laying around somewhere? Feeling a little bit festive all of a sudden. Yeah, we got to play this song with Pino, and it's a Who song. You know, when I grew up, I was about 16 and I had a job at the Long's Drugs, and they gave you a green polyester jacket and a little name tag. And you had to buy your own white shirt and your own little green clip-on tie. And you know, my job is like to get carts and clean up in aisle three. Mr. Vedder, clean up in aisle three. And then one of the things that I really would volunteer to do is stock the beer fridge. It's down in Encinitas, it's still there. The Long's Drugs, I think it's Long's Drugs number 12. And I used to ask to stock the freezer, or well, the cold where the beer was, you know. And not just, only because it was loud in there and fucking cold. But I would go through records in my head and kind of sing them. And then I kind of didn't realize that I was singing them out loud because it was so loud in there. But then the manager came and he said that some of the customers, they weren't complaining, but it was just freaking them out a little bit, because when they'd open the thing, it would say, "Real me again." Yeah, something like that. So then I had to just quiet it down a bit. But now I get to play with Pino, and you know, I didn't have a lot of friends back then, but I had every Who record. And to get to play a song off Quadrophenia with Pino, and thinking about Pete and Raj, it's really an honor. So thanks, Pino.
Chance to win. Leaves stop falling, come down is calling, loneliness starts sinking in, but I'm one. I'm one, and I can see that this is without a case.
but I can't get that even 10 look on my face. Ill-fitting clothes and I blend in the crowd. Fingers so clumsy, voice too loud.
Thank you.
Patti Smith. One of the big disappointments of many that we couldn't do this last year was there was a couple bands on the bill. Well, first of all, I should thank all the ones that were here today. Just on this stage alone, it's Maggie Rogers, Mac DeMarco. We had Johnny Roundhouse earlier. He's been here at every one. You know, I had to say Black Pumas were so nice to my daughter yesterday. They really took care of her, and that's one of her favorites. They were so sweet. I just wanted to point that out. Who am I forgetting? Oh, fucking Glenn Hanser right here. There was a group that we were so excited. We'd asked them a number of times in a row. Finally, they agreed, and we're, you know, that's why you just can't count on anything, because this is an example, who knows what the fuck had happened, but we were so excited that we were going to have Chrissy Hynde and the Pretenders here. So, in honor of her not being here, and hopefully she'll be here next year, we're going to, in the meantime, play. Are you guys ready for this one? Yeah. When it's a Chrissy song, I think people need a warning. This is a song by the Pretenders. Parks Department, everybody we've worked with in the last 5-6 years have been so good to us and understanding, and they're really the ones, if it weren't for their permission and attention and collaboration, we couldn't even think to do this, and we are so grateful. And and one of the reasons we get invited back is because you guys have taken care of the place, and we're so grateful, and we just wanted to thank everybody. And everybody in the back, how was it? Yeah. I don't remember those seats before. There you go. This song's about giving. This song's about, you know, if you have the ability to be here in this kind of place, in this kind of environment, in this country, in this state especially, it's a lucky state, then you know there's some people out there that probably have it, undoubtedly have it worse than you. And if you can always find a little bit of time, a little bit of energy, maybe a little bit of dough to help out those, you know, there's some organizations that really make it count and really care. And this song's about that. It's called Give Blood by Mr. Pete Townsend. And I dedicate this one to a great agency called CORE, run by Sean Penn. Here we go.
Andrew, Oli, Pino, come here a sec. Just say hi to all the people. Let's see everybody before we go. Mr. Pino Palladino, Andrew Watt, Mr. Chad Smith, Mr. Josh Klinghoffer, Mr. Glenn Hansen. Did I say Olivia Vetter yet? Harper Vetter, you were up here too if you want to take a bow. There's Harper. All right, we're saving some for tomorrow. We love you so much. Thanks so much for everything. There we go. Let's all take a bow on the count of three. One, two. Too kind, too cool. Thank you. Let's go. Thank you, Ohana. Thank you.